Hey guys, Night Riven here. It's time for some more Satisfactory. Hopefully things go better this time around. Last episode was like, this time around, I hope there aren't any more surprises. Luckily, I have that little, gun now that I can use to shoot the animals, the hostile animals in this game. And hopefully, when I reposition the water extractor, it will not malfunction on me again. Ooh. Before I start that up, I really should turn off everything else. That way I know nothing's going to kick in and screw things up. Sort of wish this loading screen did not take this long. Just wanted to get into this and start my base up again already. Yep. Knew that sound was coming. Okay, they aren't here, so... before I do anything too much. Stand by already. I'm going to take a stack of that stuff. Got to make sure everything is off before I go over there, because I don't want any hiccups. Just in case these things still draw enough power, even though, they aren't technically producing anything. Oh. I guess I forgot to set that one up. Oh wait, it's not even connected. Before I do anything else, I really should set that one up, just in case I forget later. Copper wire and a rod. Oh! I really should grab the Yeah. I'm going to use those copper sheets for the water extractor. And a few extra sheet coils just in case the 33 that I had was not enough. There's no ladder for this part. Hmm. Luckily, I can access it from up here. How much steel do I have? Quite a bit. Oh, I guess I forgot to set up the farthest ones. I guess I forgot to remove those power shards. Those are off. I don't need this particular cord. I don't get why it has to do that noise again. Oh, shit, it's already connected. I don't know why I thought that was not connected. How are these not powered? So, hang on. Oh shit, that's right, my chainsaw is not here. It's back at the, it's back at my body. To make the long trek back to the thing and see if this actually works. Sort of wish I wasn't doing this at night, but if it means to have if it means having power, This guy has not respawned, so... He may be back when I go the other way, but... Green power slug. This is not good. There. Where did those others go? This is not such a good idea. I sort of wish I had something to eat to get my health back. Luckily, that one has not come back. Oh, he is back. Just up there. Got him. Ah, here's my stuff. Hmm. Need to get up here fast. How? Damn it! Ah! Great. I was hoping things would go a lot better, especially since I had that gun and everything. I was hoping on getting both of them killed off before I got killed off. But if I did not get distracted by that green power slug, I would have had more health and would have survived. Good, he's not back here yet. This is what I had to deal with when I was setting up this water treatment thing and... not water treatment, but water extractor, and why I didn't want to waste a whole bunch of time trying to get this set up. But at least I know where my body died and where my stuff is. So... I know I don't have to risk... Do they have to make you sound like that? Great, he's down here now. Okay, Xeno Zapper, Chainsaw, and Rebar Gun. There. Oh, I know. I know how to get over this. I Are you seriously stuck? Come here. Come here. I'm not liking this. Do you have to move so much? Really? Yeah. Ooh. Finally. There. A little extra health. Really? Ah! Good. At least I loaded it before I ran off. This is what I had to deal with between last episode, not last episode, the Really? This is why I did not record the hassle of me trying to get my stuff back and trying to get the stupid water extractor set up, and why it took me well over 3 hours to set it up. I really hate the fact that the Coffee Stain Studios decided to say, hey, let's have the stuffs respawn! So guess what? I get killed off 20 times just to try and set up the water extractor! And it doesn't help that when I go over there, it's like, oh, his health just regenerated back to normal. And yet mine stays the same. Why can't there be more creatures like you on this planet? You know, docile. They just scamper around doing not much that would interfere with my base. Like, I know you are... Like, I know you are stuck, but... Does he have to be this close? Shots and poof! Thanks! Great! Just fucking great! Since I did technically bring a whole bunch of concrete with me, I'm going to try and rig it in such a way that I can get around those without having to piss them off every single time. Because this is getting ridiculous. To work on my base, not piss around trying to get water up and running again. I mean, yes, technically I am trying to work on my base, but not like this. Hopefully he moved back to, back where he was before. So far that guy has not respawned again, so... It's a good sign, I guess. This is getting frustrating, running all the way across this pipe just to get my stuff and die again. Ow! Really? Now he hits me? Good, he's down there. Where's my crate? Where's my crate? Okay. Actually, that would help a lot. Perfect. How much? 35. And after I'm done here, I can just easily extract everything and run before they start attacking it again. Okay. Where was that? Really deep part. Ooh, here it is. Okay. There. Hopefully this is deep enough. Go, take that out. I have a bad feeling I did not make enough. I should have. I really should have made production water extractor. As you can see, deep. really deep water. I'm really glad that he is not aggroing on me right now. Foundations, logistics. Come on, there we go. I need iron plates. I fucking need iron plates. Since I don't technically need the bottom ones. And since I have not made pipes in a while, I completely forgot that I need iron plates for this. I would feel better on the pipe than beside it. Like, I knew I needed iron rods for the, power poles, but, like, I forgot that I needed iron plates. Oh, I know. Since I'm coming back this way anyway, I might as well get the biomass material from I sure hope that's enough for a while. I need a lot of leaves, and I'm going to chainsaw down those trees along the way just in case. That way I have plenty of biomass material. For when I get everything set up again, and then I will have plenty of power to go around to get things started. Really? You're in my base. At least you are friendly, not like those other assholes. Okay. Just in case. And also, I'm kind of glad I came back. Make a few extra copper cables just in case. Better to have too much than not enough. Where's that biomass material? Ah, there it is. Your extra leaves. Did I do a little research for this already? Yup. That will be done by the time I get back, and I can do the other research. Oh. What is this? Oh, they changed the look of the reinforced plates. I'm going to convert this power slug over before I forget. Store them away just in case. Sounds like something's moving here, but... Oh, it's those guys underneath. I can't... There's definitely something moving underneath here, but it's kind of glitched into the ground, so... Oh, I thought there was a bush there. Copper sheets. An extra 50 will not hurt. Just in case the original amount I had will not cut it. And have this thing out just in case the one guy is back again. Sort of wish those would grow back. It's a bit frustrating running around with a whole bunch of those things just bare and no fruit on them to eat. He's turning. I knew he turned somewhere, but I wasn't sure where. I think it's just limestone. I'm not I'm not going to pick that up. Shit! I have to go all this way back anyway. I forgot the iron plates. All the stuff I have to do just to get water running. It would have been a lot better if they did not, if Coffee Stain Studios did not decide to say, hey, let's add water to everything, to a lot of things, and have the oil transported in pipes. I mean, it makes sense in real life to transport water and oil that way, but I would have been further along in my base by now if they had not decided to add this kind of update to the game. Since I don't technically need the reinforced iron right now, or that portable miner, five limestone. Why do I have just five limestone on me? It would be kind of nice if they let those, if they had those things come back, the berries. I don't care if they don't add a farm to this game. I just want those things to grow back. I mean, if they programmed the monsters to come back every once in a while, why not the berries? Especially if it gets to the point where we kill off so many of the monsters and then take all the berries and stuff, and then the monsters come back and guess what? No fruit to heal ourselves. And it's getting dark again. Plenty of room to get through now. Take this thing down. Go this way. Hopefully I end up aggroing that thing I saw before. Do you have to do that to me? Ugh. Fine. Sure, do that to me now! Great. Now I need more copper. Just when I thought I had enough. Well, I don't need any more copper cables, but... Really? I'll take that. So far that guy, oh, now he's respawned. Luckily, that one was easy compared to the others. Why can't the fruit do that? You know, after a while, they come back. I don't get why the coal generator is running right now, because there's no water. before I forget, I'm going to put the these three in here so that when I do get things started up and running again, I have plenty of power. Before I do anything else, just shove those back in. Mycelia. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that, but just in case I don't have enough solid biofuel. That way I will still have enough biofuel for my chainsaw. Something tells me I have too much biofuel saved up now. I sure wish they did not change the time on these recipes so that I can get this biomass fuel made sooner. You know what? I'm going to actually store the rest of this. There. And then put half in there, and then take the other half, put it inside here. Put these flower petals in here. I knew I should have grabbed an extra thing of copper just in case. But it's always hard to tell when you're out, you know, out by the water. Hopefully it will not take too long. I thought the water extractor most likely kicked in the moment I restored. Oh wait, no, it did not because I did not flip the switch to turn everything back on again. Luckily, there is no limit to how much power that can go through these power through the power wires. So glad I cleared this tree out of the way. And the other tree as well. Sort of wish I did not grab so much biofuel. But at least I have a lot of extra just in case something like this happens again. nothing following me, so that's a good sign. There. Now to start the power up. Hopefully there's enough biomass fuel inside there. There we go. Seriously? You know what? This episode has gone on long enough. Between this episode and next one, I'm going to figure out what the hell went wrong and fix it. But until then, I hope you enjoyed this episode. You know, if you did, hit the like button. Subscribe if you're new. And thanks for watching. Until next episode. Bye.